review from part one, I was vacationing in Utah and was camped just north of the city of Moab. I woke up early the next morning to a perfect sunny day. I ate my breakfast and headed over to Arches National Park. I went directly to an area called the Windows section. I wanted to get a good look at the Turret Arch in early morning light. Here's another view of Turret Arch. And here's a photograph of it. And here it is looking through North Window Arch. Directly across the parking lot for the trail to Turret Arch is the trailhead to Double Arch, my next destination. Here's some of the scenery on the short and easy half-mile trail. Double Arch stands 104 feet high and with a span of 148 feet. You might recognize it from the opening scene from the Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade movie. Here's what it looks like to stand underneath the arch. It was only a short drive from the window section to a spot called the Garden of Eden. The area is full of tall, strange rock formations that you can walk around. This will give you an idea of the size of these formations. You can just see that rock climbing and that formation in the Garden of Eden. In a garden of Eden. Located next to the road junction to the Windows section is the famous Balanced Rock. Although dwarfed by the huge monolith next to it, the Balanced Rock stands a total of 128 feet tall. The boulder at the top of the formation is in itself 55 feet tall and weighs a whopping 3,500 tons. That's me standing in front of the rock. Next, I doubled back to the entrance of Arches National Park to a trail called Park Avenue. I didn't go on the trail itself and only took pictures from the viewpoint. But if you've got an itching to do some walking, the trail is 2 miles out and back, or 1 mile if you're lucky enough to have a shuttle car. I guess these rock formations do kind of resemble giant skyscrapers. A car on the road in the distance. There are plenty of spots to pull over in Arches National Park and admire the rock formations and the beauty of this place. And I'm headed to my next destination. A little rainwater left over from last night's downpour. This is some of the scenery at the LaSalle Mountains viewpoint. I'm still at the LaSalle Mountains viewpoint. This is the view a quarter turn to the right. Off in the distance is my next destination, the formation called the Oregon. I'm up the road just a little bit, and here's a closer view of the Oregon. Across the road is a formation called the Three Gossips. And close to it is one called Sheep Rock. Can you see the sheep at the top of the formation? This giant monolith, found almost directly across the road, is called the Tower of Babel. Back on the road, and here's some of the scenery. Next, I stopped off at the trailhead to Sand Dune Arch and Broken Arch. Only went to Sand Dune Arch. Some of the scenery along the trail. Here I am at Little Sand Dune Arch. Then, I doubled back to the trailhead for the famous Delicate Arch. It's really not a trail up there. You just hike up the slick rock. You can see from all the people that this 3 mile round trip hike is very popular. Here's the trail nearing the destination. Don't be like some people I saw on the trail and mistake that little arch for the real deal. Finally, after mostly hiking uphill for 1.5 miles, I turn a corner and there it is, Delicate Arch. The Delicate Arch stands in the giant bowl-like formation. Like I said before, you can tell by the number of people there that it's a popular hike. The freestanding Delicate Arch rises 60 feet above the ground. Sitting there, looking at this wonder of nature, I could think of only one thing. I could be here, or I could be at work right now. back down to the trailhead. After that, I left the park for a few hours. For one thing, I wanted to check into my motel. I wanted to stay in a motel for one night so I could charge up my phone and my camera batteries. The second reason, and the main reason, was I was hungry. I ended up going to Milt's Stop and Eat in Moab. I got there just before they closed. Good thing too, because they make an excellent cheeseburger and onion rings. Then it was back to Arches National Park and back to the window section to get some pictures at sunset. Here's the view of the trail leading up to the arch called the North Window. Here's a picture of me and the North Window. Another shot of the North Window. You can really tell how big that arch is by those people standing in it. Here's a picture of the North Window and the South Window. Together they're called the Spectacle. I woke up early the next morning, I mean really early, and drove over to Main Street in Moab to get some breakfast at the Moab Diner. Once inside, the Moab Diner will remind you of an old 50s diner. I can attest that the blueberry pancakes with bacon and eggs were excellent. But once again, I made a pig of myself. After breakfast, I went back to Arches National Park and took the road as far as it would go to the Devil's Garden Trailhead. It was difficult to drive straight there because there are so many rock formations along the road to see. I wanted to stop at every one of them. Here are just a few of them. I planned hiking to the Double O Arch. At 4 miles round trip, it would be the longest hike I would do in Arches. Okay. This is the start of the Devil's Garden Trail, headed to Double O Arch. This is one tall, big, flat piece of sandstone at the beginning of the trail. Here's a sign pointing the way. Some of the fantastic scenery along the trail. A couple of hikers up ahead of me, heading into that patch of rocks. After an easy hike of not even a mile, I come to Landscape Arch. With a span of 290 feet, it's believed to be the longest arch in the world. A spur trail used to go directly under the arch, but after a few boulders broke off of it, that was discontinued. Farther along the trail, here's this row of fin formations. Looks like I'm headed in the right direction. It looks like I've got to climb up that rock. That so-called rock turned out to be a giant fin formation. Here are some people ahead of me walking on it. There was a good 10 to 15 foot drop on either side of the formation. That's me showing off. A little scenery alongside the trail. I'm getting pretty close to my destination. There are a couple of hikers coming to the end of the fin formation. I told you it's quite a drop. Finally, after hiking 2 miles, I come to the Double O Arch, one arch sitting on top of the other. Here's a picture of me standing in front of the lower arch. I'm about 6'2" tall. This will give you an idea of the size of the arches. Taking a look at some fin formations through the upper arch of the Double O Arch. Picture of the Double O Arch. Looks like the perfect place to sit down and take a break. I've rested up and I'm heading back to the trailhead, and now I'm back on top of that fin formation. On the way out, I took a little detour to see Partition Arch. Looking through Partition Arch at some of the scenery found in the national park. Next up, a side trip to Navajo Arch. And here's a little picture of Navajo Arch. Snow-capped mountains in the distance, more rock formations ahead of me. A couple of hikers heading towards Double O Arch as I'm heading out. Some giant fin formations alongside the trail. And finally, back to the Double O Arch trailhead. And that was all the time I had for Arches National Park. I left the park in Moab and started driving south to my next destination, the Needle section of Canyonlands National Park.